गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम टू योर मैथ्स क्लासेस। वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 3A, सो नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट विथ 3B। सम स्टूडेंट्स इवन हैव शोन देयर 3A ऑल्सो, इट्स वेरी गुड। लाइक मृणाल इज देयर, मैनी मोर स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर हु आर सबमिटिंग देयर वर्क, जिया इज देयर, बट मैनी स्टूडेंट्स दे हैव नॉट शोइंग एनी रिस्पॉन्स टू बैडमिंटन। ओके, सो एवरी वन विल कम्प्लीट एक्सरसाइज 3A and after that the same you will deposit or sorry you will submit on my personal window. Okay, now let's see what we have to do in exercise 3B. So this is exercise 3B. Exercise 3B is regarding your multiplication. This is the first question. Without actual multiplication you have to find the product. Okay, without doing the actual multiplication you will find out the product. So let's see how we will do this questions. So this is the first question. Now let's see the solution, that how we will solve this questions. Okay, now we are going to do this. Remember one thing, question is saying that without doing the actual multiplication you are going to solve the question. Okay, without doing the actual multiplication we have to solve this questions. Okay, so what we will do, like we are dividing. Now forget about this decimal, 10, 100, how we are multiplying. First I will write down the number the same, 8, 3, 3, 1, 5. I have taken all the digits, I am not putting decimal right now. Okay, and when we have to multiply with 10 I will put 10. Okay, regarding the decimal I will tell you later on, right now just do this thing. Okay, 9, 8 is the two digits and after that two zeros. I am taking these zeros and I am putting at last. Two zeros is there and I will take the digit. Digits, two zeros. Again digit, in front of a number zero has no value, that's why I have not written. Now three zeros. After that 7, 7, 9. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 0. Now what are the digits? 6, 0, 6, 8. Then three zeros. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now I will consider the decimal. Right now what I add in all the digits, number of zeros I have put as it is, 0000000000000. Now what I will do, I will check that how many decimal places are there. This is the decimal. After that how many digits are there, count 1, 2, 3. 3 digits are there. So from here I will count 1, 2, 3 and then I will put the decimal. Decimal places should be the same. 3 are there, 3 are there. Here, how many digits are there after decimal? 1. That means after 1 digit, I will put the decimal. Now, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, here, 1, 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3. And you will count always from the right hand side when you are putting the decimal. 1 digit, 1. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I will put the decimal. Now we know that after decimal zero means has no value, no impact. So I will just write down the numbers without putting the zero. If after decimal any zero is there, decimal zero, it has no value. Okay, there's no need to write down that. 6, 2, 4, 0.5, 35. Decimal zeros are there only. Okay, now 7, 7, 9, 0, 0. After decimal zero has no impact. And same here, 6, 0, 6, 8. This will be the answer. I have not actually multiplied the numbers like we are multiplying now. 1, 2, 3. We are counting the tables now. I just put the digits and the zeros. This is the rule apply only when the zeros are there. Okay, 10 to the power numbers are there, like 10, 100, 1000. Okay, understood. Now we are moving to question number 2. Now let's see what is the question number 2. Now in question number 2, multiply the following. You have to multiply these numbers. Okay, so this will be the again normal multiplication. Let's see the questions. First question is 5.2 multiply with 52. After that second is there, 3.5, 32. Then third is there, 6.53 I am written on top, 17 I am writing. It will not impact anything. Okay, you can do like that. It will not impact anything. You can do this. Okay, now because 3 2 ja 6 and 2 3 ja is 6. Okay, after that the fourth one is 60.845. Okay, this is the fourth one. Now the fifth I am taking here, 37.385 into 7 and then 337.57 into 3. Okay, these are the numbers. So now let's see the solution, how I will multiply. 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. Then I will put one cross. Now the next number is 5. 5 2s are 10, 5 5s are 25, 26. Now I will sum up the numbers 4, 0, 6, 1, 7 and 2. Okay, this is the number. Now I will count the decimal places. How many decimal places is there? Only one. One decimal place is there. So I will put decimal after one digit. From my right hand side I will count 1. This will be the answer. Okay. See again the question. 2 5 ja 10. 2 3 ja 6 7. 3 5 ja 15. 3 3 ja 9 10. Now I will add the number 0, 7 5 12, 1 1. Again I will count the decimal place. Only one decimal place is there. That's why I put the decimal after one digit. Okay, it's will be written as 112 because after decimal zero has no impact. Okay, now let's see this number again for the practice. 7 3 ja 21, 7 5 ja 35, 7 6 ja 42. Now 3 5 6, I will add the numbers 1, 7 and 3 10, 11 11. Okay, now how many decimal places are there? 1 2. So I'll put the decimal after two numbers, 1 2. So my this will be the answer. Only count the decimal places. In rest of the multiplication decimal has no value. At last I will put it. Okay, now next number, 5 8 ja 40, 5 6 ja 30. Okay, 4 8 ja 32, 4 6 ja 24. Now I will sum up 0, 6 3 7 2. Now I will check how many decimal places are there. 1. So I will put the decimal after 1. Again, if after decimal all numbers are 0, all digits are 0, it has no impact. I will write down 2736. This will be my final answer. Okay, now let's see this one. With 7 I have to multiply with this. Okay, so I will multiply. Let's check. 7 5 ja 35, 7 8 ja 56 and 3 9, 7 3 ja 21, 6, 7 7 ja 21, 22 23, 7 7 ja 49, 51, 7 3 ja 21, 26, 2 6 1, 6 9 5. Now count the decimal places. How many are there? 1 2 3. 3 are there, so I will count from right hand side, 1, 2, 3. That means 695, it will be the answer. Okay, let's check one more question is there. 3, 7, ja 21, 3, 5, ja 15, 3, 7, ja 21, 3, 3, ja 9, 3, 3, ja 9. Okay, how many decimal places are there? 1, 2. So I'll put the decimal after two digit. 1, 2. This will be the answer. Now let's move to the next question. Question number 3. Again you have to find out the product. Only the difference is there. There you are having only one decimal place. But here you are having the decimal place here and here in both the numbers. Okay. So let's see how the multiplication will take place. Question number 3. Part 1 I am doing first. 0.2 multiply with 2.5. okay, so I can write down like that. Okay, I can do like that also. Okay, the greater one I am taking at top so that the multiplication will be easy. 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4 and 1 5. Now the next number is 0, there is no benefit of multiplying. Now count the decimal places. 1. and one at bottom also. So 1, 1, 2. I will count both together. So 1, 2. After 2, I will put the decimal, and before decimal always there should be a digit. If nothing is there, I will put 0. So this will be the answer. Okay, let's see one more. If not getting the point, no problem. The second is 5.25 multiply with 4.3. The greater number I am writing at top, it will not make any difference. Okay, 3 5 15, 3 2 6, 3 5 15. Now 4 5 20, 4 2 8, 4 5 20. Now get the sum, 5 7 5 2 2. Now calculate the decimal places. How many decimal places are there? 1 2 3. Count all, upside and downside both. 1 2 3. Count from right hand side, 1 2 3. Then you will put your decimal. This will be the answer. Okay, I hope you have understood. You can do it only because just you have to take care of the decimal. Rest of the things are same. Okay, take one more. 0.45 multiply with 4.3. Now 3 5 15, 3 4 12, 12 and 1 13. I will not go use this 0 because this is the last one, it has no impact. Okay, now 4 5 20, 4 4 16, 17 18. Now sum up, 5 3 9 1. How many decimal places are there? 1 2 and 3. So I will count from my right hand side, 1 2 3. So this will be the answer. Okay, now I will do the fifth part. It is 0.086 multiply with 0.85. okay, 5 6 are 30, 5 8 are 40, 8 6 are 48, 8 8 are 64, 68. Okay, the remaining digits are 0, so I will not go further. It will not give any impact. Zeros are zeros, are no benefit. Okay, now I will add the numbers. Now count the decimal places, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I will put decimal after 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth number is not there, so I will put 1, 0. At front I can put the zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now digits are completed, I can put decimal. But before decimal there should be a digit, that's why I will put one more 0. Understood the point? How I have done. Now see one more. 3.004 2.65. okay, multiply. Now I will add the numbers. Okay, 0 6 10 6 7. Okay, now count how many decimal places are there. 1 2 3 4 5. So put decimal after 5. 1 2 3 4 5. Sorry, 1 2 3 4 5. Yes, right, decimal will come here. So this will be the answer. Okay, I think that up to this it is understood. Multiplication is easy, only you have to put the decimal at last by counting it. Now find the following continued products. Okay, now continued products are there, you have to find out that. So let's see how we will calculate this. Okay, so first part I am doing 3.25 into 10. It will be 325 and then 10. Now 1 2 1 2, two decimal places I will use. Directly I can do this. Okay, in second portion, first of all you will multiply these two numbers, whatever answer you are getting, then you will multiply with 1000. Okay, now let's see how I will do it. Second part is 6.32 multiply with 4.56. so it will be 4. Now I will add the numbers. Now I will count the decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, but this is the remaining part because I have to calculate this value. This is the complete question. Okay, after multiplying these two numbers, I have got this value. Still 1000 multiplication is remaining there, so which I can multiply like that only. First I will put the digits, after that I will put three zeros. Now I will calculate decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4. I will count 1, 2, 3, 4, then I will put the decimal. Okay, that means 28699.2. After decimal zero has no impact, this will be the final answer. Okay, now let's see the third one. 0.04 into 4. So first is 4 4 16, but I have to calculate the decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 should be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I can put the decimal because 5 decimal places are there. Still it is remaining to multiply. Now 16 4 64. Now how many decimal places are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I will put after 6, I will count from my right hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will put decimal and this will be the answer. Okay, now I am doing part 4th. 1.01 0.101 0.0101. okay, so first of all I will multiply these numbers 1.01 and 0.101. okay, so it will be 101, then 00, then again it will be 101. If you get the sum 10201, count the decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that means the product is, their product is 10201. But still this multiplication is left. Okay. So now I will multiply these two numbers, then I will see what is my answer. Okay. I will multiply now. So first as it is, then zeros, then the third number will be again 10201. Okay, now the rest of the digit is zero, no benefit to multiply. 1030301. Count the decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then I will put decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, that means if I am multiplying these two numbers, answer will be 1. Okay, so this will be the final answer. Okay, rest of the questions which I have leave from the in between, that you will do by yourself. One part I have leave now, that you will do by yourself. Okay, so this up to these questions you will do in your notebook. So first preference is given that you have to complete these questions in your notebook. Take care of yourself, class. Okay, thank you, beta.